Hello everyone, my name is Udit. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about the iOS systems design interview that comes up for iOS engineering candidates. There are plenty of companies which run iOS systems design round for candidates. Facebook, Robinhood, Google, Tinder, etc. are great examples. And these differ sufficiently from traditional system design interviews in that these are much more app-focused than back-end-focused, that it's really worth investing into preparing for them properly. At the end of this video, you should have three takeaways. One, what your interviewers are looking for, and therefore what these interviews usually end up covering in terms of ground. Two, some tips on how to crack this sort of interview. And finally, a couple of recently asked interview questions to practice against. First topic then, what your interviewer is trying to assess. Your interviewer is trying to understand your ability to solve a complicated iOS engineering design problem. Or in other words, can you architect a high-level solution to a problem that has multiple concepts and components involved? Ideally, you're going to be covering a range of topics that are going to prove relevant in the actual job. So the view layer, the networking, storage, cache, etc. The three things that they're specifically looking for is one, technical skills, reflected through your knowledge of different technologies, awareness of side effects and system interactions, the trade-offs involved, the ability to build something that is flexible and which scales effectively. And let me give you an example to articulate what I mean. If you're talking about networking, for instance, are you going to use GCD or operational queues? Which is a better fit for your use case and why? What are the things you need to take into account and so on? So you really want your experience to shine through here. There might be a super elegant solution that's going to be really hard to implement given certain constraints that you are aware of. Flag this kind of thing out. The second thing your interviewer is looking for is structure and approach. So do you scope the problem? Do you clarify requirements or constraints? Do you have a methodology that you follow? Are you familiar with MVVM and MVC? Can you apply these principles to an actual design problem? Did you dive straight into the problem and then jump around within the different topics? Or did you come up with a framing of how you're going to solve it step by step? Do you actually understand the remit of the business problem and how this leads into the use cases that you're solving for? Did you drive the discussion or were you passively reacting to wherever your interviewer moved you to? Which is then the third part, the communication and collaboration that they're filtering for. How do you interact with your interviewer? Are you able to explain your thinking and go into the right level of detail? Do you have a partnership approach to solving this problem? Did you just make an assumption or do you discuss these assumptions with your interviewer? A good example here is a lot of candidates actually wonder in interviews if they can use third-party libraries as part of their solution. My recommendation would be just ask at the stage you've come up with this idea. It reveals that you know these options exist. It also shows that you have a bit of maturity for understanding that this is something to be discussed rather than assumed. So it's win-win. Leading on from this, we have 5 tips for you to really crack this interview, and this is probably the most critical part of this video. Tip number 1, scope and clarify. These questions are super broad in nature and you really want to narrow down the definition into something that you can actually attack in 40-45 minutes that you have. It's also a major side benefit for you in that experts choose the area they want to focus on since they'll have a list of things that they want to assess. And it's good for you because it narrows down the scope to something that you can actually solve in that time. Good questions that you could potentially ask at this stage are, how many users are we talking about? What does the experience need to be? Are there any constraints we are aware of? Are there any error states that we should try to handle or constraints around latency? How are we going to be storing messages? Are we allowed to store them locally, for instance? What are the basic features we're going to need to build and support in our minimum viable product? Tip number 2 is to then have a structured and methodical approach to solving it. My general recommendation is to split things into the discrete layers, all the way starting from view, controller, network, storage, and cache, since this is how you're going to design the system in real life. And then within these, discuss concepts like performance, efficiency, and scale, as well as potentially product-specific nuances that you need to solve for, like time zones, or accessibility, or scrolling. Which then brings me to my third tip. Watch out for hints. Let me give an example. Maybe you're designing some kind of calendar element and your interviewer asks, hey, are you sure you're going to just want to store one single timestamp for this event? This is an explicit hint that you might be missing something. Maybe you need to store a start and end time, or maybe there's some complexity related to time zones that you simply haven't taken into account. So use this as an opportunity to either pivot or clarify and ask them what they mean, or explain the thinking because you might already have thought of what they're concerned about, which then neatly flows over into my fourth tip, that you should constantly think out loud, since when you're solving your problem, it's really, really useful for your interviewer to know what you're thinking and how you're approaching it. Even more so because then they can course correct you if you go down a tangent that isn't going to solve it, or if you go down a tangent they really aren't interested in exploring with you. Final tip, the fifth one, practice. There are three ways to practice. The first way is to just practice against yourself. Think of the architecture of apps that you regularly use. Google the knowledge that's present on the internet. You'll find loads of thinking behind these apps online, like on the Facebook engineering blog, for instance. There's also an interview question bank on Prepfully's website. I've included the link in the description. These are all questions collected from candidates who've recently done interviews. So good source material for you to start thinking of what kind of stuff you could get asked. The second way to practice is with friends or peers. This helps you get into the groove of an interview setting. It smoothens out your delivery. And the third and most important way is to practice with professionals. So Prepfully has 18 iOS engineers who've been helping candidates with mocks. They've collectively helped so many candidates that they've got great insight into the common mistakes that people make, as well as advice on how to improve and fine-tune your answers from good to great. Good, to the last part then, interview questions for practice. There's a much longer list of these on our website because, again, we curate these from candidates who are actually interviewing at these places. But here's three just to get you started. Question one, how would you create a Twitter clone, specifically the infinite news feed part of it? This was asked at Twitter. Question number two, design the architecture for Uber's driver app. And this was asked at Uber. Question number three, how would you build your own version of Dropbox's iOS app? And this was asked at Facebook. Good, that's all from us for this guide then. Once you feel ready for some practice, or if you just want a sense check of your preparation level, you can book an online mock interview with an iOS engineer on Prepfully. We've got several from Facebook, Tinder, Robinhood, Google, Amazon, a couple of other companies. As I said before, they've helped a ton of candidates with exactly this type of iOS systems design interview, so they can provide incredible value in a very short amount of time if you're looking to get an edge. In addition, I'm going to link to all the other useful resources that I mentioned, not just the question bank, but also things like blog posts and articles that we've curated on this topic. Feel free to check those out if you feel they'll be helpful to your preparation. If you have follow-up questions about this interview, please feel free to ask in the comments below. If you found this video useful, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks and good luck.
Thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, please subscribe. Our website is prepfully.com. We've got lots of interview questions there. You can also schedule a mock interview with one of our experts. You can find the link in the description below. All the best from us at Prepfully, and we hope you totally rock your interview.